diga.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you, ma'am?
I'm okay. Yeah. Parang I don't like all these mics.
Okay lang po.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay,
okay
lang po.
Ma'am, just stay in the
room. Ma'am, kailangan po may mic.
So, shall I talk?
Yeah, ma'am. Yeah, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. All right. So, what I'd like to say, it is the constitutional right of every Filipino. I might cry here, but I know.
No, ma'am, no.
Okay, it's a constitutional right of every Filipino. It is the constitutional right of every Filipino to a clean and healthy environment. It is our right in the Constitution. And that is premier above all. And it is the duty of government to grant our people this right. And when people make choices influenced and based on business interests, transgressing the right of every Filipino to what God has given them, it is wrong. It is wrong. And I applaud the senators and or the congressmen that have voted according to their conscience. What can I say about the ones? Yeah. This was not my dream. It was a dream and a promise that we had for the country. And it is unfortunate that business interests have in fact run the day, because that's really what it is.
So, ma'am, anong plano mo na rin? Anong plano mo na rin?
I don't know. I have to think about it. First thing I want to do is I want to meet with my staff, because we have planned many things, sayang. Dami pero ng DNR. We have planned many things. We have dreamed of partnerships to do on the ground. I have no doubt. We have planned many things with my staff and with the people that I met. And should I talk in Tagalog? Marami kaming plano, sayang, na sana sa pamamagitan ng pag-alaga ng kalikasan, doon manggagaling ang pakinabang ng lahat. We were gonna do it, you know. I was excited kasi may pera ang pamahalaan. May pera ang DNR. And I wanted to use that money to create models na pwede alisin yung kahirapan dito sa bansa. And it is very sad that in the commission of appointments, clearly business interests have run the day. And I think that needs to be reevaluated, because how can a body which is mandated to make decisions based on the common good make decisions based on business interests? Well, what else can you say? You know? If the ones who voted no, explain it. What are the reasons for? Explain it.
Ma'am, ano pong mensahe niyo doon sa mga komunidad na umaasa sana na bubuti yung kanilang buhay pero dahil na hindi natuloy yung confirmation niyo?
Okay, again, I will say it again. It is the constitutional right of every Filipino for a clean and healthy environment. It is the duty of every Filipino to make sure that their fellow Filipinos get that. So my call to all the Filipinos out there, I totally love you all. And this is not... Then we take it on. You take it on. Take on the fight.
So, kailan pa rin yung advocacy niyo, ma'am?
you know, advocacy is talking, talking, you know, but I feel that you take it on. I've showed it on video, the destruction that happens, the people that are suffering. You take it on wherever you are, and you activate for the constitutional, God-given right of every Filipino to a clean and healthy environment.
So,
ma'am,
you have to vacate your position today?
I'll talk to my staff. Okay, can I say something also?
Yes, ma'am.
My choice for DNR Secretary is President Duterte.
Yeah.
Woo! Yes, yeah, because you know, you are to be what's happening here is to be the it's so powerful. I didn't know you DNR Secretary. You are the authority over the use of our resources, and you have the authority and the money to eradicate poverty. It's not an amazing position. And I can't think of any other person. You know, it needs guts, it needs tapang, because you have to step on business interests. There's no way. You have to step on business interests. And two, it needs integrity. It needs total tapang. And I think whoever they're going to put there, if it's just a newbie or somebody young, I don't think you can get somebody young to do this job, man. And thirdly, what the job also does need is development experience, because that's what I bring into the picture. Kasi I know how to eradicate poverty, to care of the environment. At sana ayan ang gusto sana ng gawin. So I will still offer my services in terms of development, because that's my skill. But in terms of leading the agency, I don't think you can get anyone new. You get flowers. Look at this, no? Anyone who's here, if they have the guts and the courage to step on business interests, you will get killed. Yeah, so he should take it on. That's my choice, President Duterte. He's the only one that has the guts.
Pero in hindsight, tingin nyo iba sana yung situation kung tinulungan kayo ng presidente sa mga senators and congressmen para ma-confirm kayo?
I have no idea, but I know he's made several public statements. I don't know how politics works, eh? But I know he has made several public statements many times over. I don't know how politics works. Can he do that? I don't know.
Ma'am, pero yung nag-file ng reklamo sa Ombudsman.
Yeah, that's the 2 million pesos.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, I again, that's what I said. You know, I it's in my Facebook, and you know, maybe Selena can put it out later. I mean, last night I slept at midnight. You know, 11:48. And kasi iniisip ko yan, kasi nakita ko sa deliberations. In the hearing, ang laging tinatanong yung law, yung 2 million. At yan, parang yan ang thrust ng deliberation. And then, you know, when I was about to sleep, sitting down alone in my room, because, you know, my son is, my kids were not there. These were my thoughts, and it's on Facebook, but I'll share it with you. At the end of the day, the Philippine Constitution is the premier law of the country, right? Every Filipino, again, I'm so repetitious already, has the right to a clean and healthy environment. So why shouldn't that right of the Constitution be more important than anything else? And then you're talking about due process, and you're talking about the rights of the mining company and things like that. Hey, you know, but what about the rights of our people to a clean and healthy environment? Isn't that even more important? Why are we giving such a primer to this and this and this? Why don't we take what every Filipino should have? Isn't that more important? I mean, why is there such a primer on this? I mean, what did I ask? I said, because there's stockpile there, and from the stockpile there, you're going to remove it, right? And I agree that the stockpile should be removed, because if you don't remove the stockpile, it's bad for the environment. All I'm saying is that they're going to make so much money from the stockpile, not a little. The cost of 1 ton of stockpile is $12. We have how many millions of tons of stockpile? In Zambales alone, it's 2.6 million. And then I calculated, they're going to make more than 10 billion pesos. In Zambales alone, 1.4 billion pesos. That's so much money that they're going to make from the stockpiles. All I'm asking is that you give 2 million pesos for every hectare of farmland na dadismaya yung mga magsasaka dahil sa operations nyo. That's how you made your money. You made your money and you have disadvantage of farmland. What is wrong with giving 2 million pesos for the farm, for the farmers you have disadvantage? You already are going to make so much money. Why are you making... What's wrong with giving 2 million pesos? Parang you should do it. Why should I even tell you to do it? You should do it because it's the right thing to do. You're making so much money, so just give it. What's wrong? 2 million pesos. And I'm just saying, for the 2 million pesos, for the farmlands that have been devastated out of the rehab area. Because when you mine, you have rehab funds, okay? You have rehab funds. And so, so that money is for the rehab area. Ano mangyayari sa magsasaka na out of the rehab area? Sino mag-aalaga sa kanila? Yung taxpayers' money? Sino nagtismaya sa kanila? Yung minero. E bakit yung taxpayers' money mag-alaga dyan? And when you're making so much money, why can't you set aside 2 million pesos for the farmlands you have devastated? It is the right thing to do, and it is mandated by the Constitution, and it is the right of the DNR Secretary to mandate processes so that our people don't suffer. What did I do? I just don't want our farmers to suffer. Why don't you just give the money? You're making so much money. And I'm not saying to put up a certain fund or whatever, you know, that's the law. Just set aside the money so that our farmers don't suffer. Because of what you did to make your money, you have made those farmers suffer. Isn't it right that you give 2 million pesos per hectare for the farmlands you have devastated? What's wrong with that? And you're going to blame me and we discuss it for an hour and a half. Why don't you talk about the common good? We talked about an hour and a half, you know, like in the confirmation hearing about these 2 million pesos. What are we talking about? Why don't you discuss the Constitution with as much passion as you're doing this thing for the miners, whatever, that why will they give 2 million pesos? I mean, I really feel that if we, you know, there are laws and regulations, and I will follow the law, and I committed to all the... I committed to all the senators and congressmen. I will follow the law. Okay, but when we decide what laws, there are thousands of laws. So we decide how to navigate. But at the end of the day, when we follow the laws, are meant to service our people. It's not meant to be followed blindly. Why are the laws there to service our people? So are you gonna use one law so that our farmers don't suffer? Is that what that's all about? Why don't you go to the Philippine Constitution? Why don't you go to the Philippine Mining Act? Why don't you go to the Clean Air, Clean Water? Why are you choosing the law that our farmers will suffer? What is wrong with that? And the people that are there in the Commission on Appointments, you that discuss all these rules and regulations, what's that for? Why are you there? Why are you there? To service the people. What is your mandate? To service the people. And on what pretext are you making decisions? Think about that. They're there to service the people. And so you're talking about this law and that mining company. My God, you know. My God, you know. Why are we there? And if our lawmakers don't stand by the God-given right of every Filipino to a clean and healthy environment, what hope do we have? That's government. You have this and that, right? And then you have the rich, you have the poor, and then the government makes decisions. So if government co-ops to big business, which I feel it has, some of them, then what hope do the poor have? And listen, what message are we giving here? If you want to be confirmed, never go against big business. That's what you're saying. If you want to do this, do you think any DNR secretary will do what I've done? You'll never get confirmed. Yeah, and it's not like I went against all mining. I mean, I passed 13 mining, and I'm even going to work with some mining companies to fund the peace area. We can bring on peace, you know, but you cannot kill the environment, because if you kill the environment, you kill everything. One third of the Filipino depends on our natural resources. Sinong nagdudusa pag winawasak yung kalikasan? Sino? Yung manihirap. That's the fact, you know, the rich have air cons and all like this. Who suffers if you kill the environment? It's the poor. And whose duty is it to protect our people? It's the government. And when you make decisions based on business interests, you have shirked your responsibility. You have lost the moral ascendancy to rule the government, because to you, business and money is more important than the welfare of our people. So take it as that. Who's gonna do the same thing now? No? I'm sorry, I'm really passionate, but I'm here.
Ma'am, may pinal ko na graph case sa inyo sa Office of the Ombudsman, Attorney Lorna Capuna from City Nigel. What can you say about that?
I don't know what the draft case is. And you might think about it now that I'm running for confirmation, all of these things are popping up. You know, I don't know, is Manila standard here? Because they said I'm a drug addict. I don't even eat white sugar. Yeah? And then, what did they say? I have brain cancer. I mean, I'm really, really healthy. I mean, all the lies that have come. So just go figure. I mean, these things that have... Okay, this is what I want to tell you. This is not my advocacy. This is your all advocacy. You are all Filipinos. It is your duty to take care of every Filipino in the way that you can. Yeah.
Ma'am, paano niyo po i-ensure na yung pong mga nauna lang plano niyo sa DENR?
Well, that's why I have to meet with my staff. You know, that's why we, because I knew that, you know, the problem with politicians is what you see is not what you get. And you'll say something and then ibagagawin. So you don't, no, that's how it is. So I knew since politics was unpredictable, what we did before, I sat with my staff, I'm going to do everything that I needs to be done. So if I don't get confirmed, at least nagawa na. Number one is the open pit mining. It's so bad, man. Did you see it, the video? Did you guys see it?
We should show it.
I can be a lalay of President Duterte in DNR. So strong, you know why? Because if he goes and sees the suffering, he'll stop. He doesn't like our people to suffer. Okay, but did you see it? Have you guys seen it? Heal the Hurt?
Yes,
yes.
Oh, it was good, diba?
How many regrets na tinanggap niyo pagiging DNR?
Ah, no, I've no regrets. Look at all of you here. No? And now people, I think the mining industry is really scared.
Pero ma'am, how did you know about the rejection? Who called you?
What, darling?
I got several calls,
but then they said you shouldn't go until it's official. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think 8 voted for. Mm-hmm. That's what I was told. 8 voted for me and 16 again.
So mostly congressmen, ma'am, voted against.
Well, if you look at the, yeah. Huh? The chair of the commission on appointments in Congress is a minor. Mm-hmm. How did that ever happen? Because the first time, the first time my first hearing, I came very naive, no? And I was thinking, oh, like that. And then I got shocked. I said, what happened here, no? People that said they were nice, and then committed, and then nagbayanos. That was real shock for me. But that's the time when I got emotional. But and then after that, you know, I meditate, no? Then I realized you can't control. The outcome, diba?
So
you have no control over politics, magulo eh. So I decided that the most important thing for me is to be true. And so since the politics is so unpredictable, then what I decided is that before my confirmation hearing, I will do everything that I can which is necessary, like our policies. First of all, I have a best thing. Can I introduce to you my team? Okay, we enacted policies which would bring on social justice. Like for example, now we made it illegal, because before you can have acid water there in the open pit. Now we made it illegal. You know, you can't do that. What are the other things you can mention? Okay, and then the land, because we issued policy changes in land, because if you have land, usually you wanna. I made a policy that if there's land, the first chance at getting that land should be given to the poor communities living there. It should never be given to real estate brokers, to military cooperatives or whatever. It should be given to the poor. And if it's given to the poor, you don't stop at giving them land. We have to help them with money. We have to help them with resources and all the way up to marketing. Where's Sylvia?
Here.
Hey, babes, come here. I have a general here, Sylvia. Come here, Marlo. Come here. Sylvia, babes, come here. I have two generals in my office. What is General Ordon? Where's Art? Yes, this is General Art Valdez. Sylvia Darley comes.
Mama, tama ang loob nyo na na-reject yung...
The most important thing is to keep light and I love you. No, I actually love you all and I love the country. And whatever I'm saying here is not out of anger. But it's out of a stand for truth. Because love is not, oh, I love, love. It's wrong, you know. When our lawmakers, some of them, don't stand for the constitutional right of every Filipino, and they are rather influenced by business interests, it's really very wrong. And if I don't go at it like that, they'll keep on doing that. So you make them afraid. I had no idea. We were counting yesterday, and it looked like I had the numbers, so I'm a little bit surprised.
So how do we continue the fight, ma'am? How do we continue to fight for our rights and for taking care of the environment?
All of you and each and every Filipino, that you must know that it's in the Constitution. Dapat alam nyo na nasa Constitution ang... What do you call this? Ang karapatan. Ang karapatan ng bawat Pilipino mag... Sorry, my Tagalog.
Tamasa?
So malalim.
Tamasa. Nang malinis, nakalikasan.
Bagong kalikupan.
Yan! Anong sabi niya? Correct siya.
Bagong kalikupan.
Yan. It's a constitutional right.
Karapatan
ng bawat Pilipino sa isang malinis at healthy. Yan, makinapang. Anyway, you all have to know that that's a constitutional right. It's our constitutional right. So you all need to know that. You know, some of you may not have known it. It is your God-given right. And that is much more important than any amount of money that anyone wants to make. Do you understand?
Yes.
The money that people want to make is never more important than your constitutional right. It must never be allowed. The business interest must never, ever, ever be more important than your constitutional right. And that's why I don't like open pit mining. Because the open pits will be there forever and a day. The people will suffer forever and a day. The open pits mine, I mean, in Basay, the toxicity level there is 500 times more than the maximum. Just ko ano ba yan? In Palawan, the open pit mine there, the pollution level, the 70% of the population is suffering from mercury poisoning. What's that all about? You know, in Marinduque, the 78 children there have brain disease. What about them? You know, you look at my Facebook. I have a video there, it's really nice.
Ma'am, since meron na po kayong nilatag bago po itong decision ng CA, ano po yung sasabihin nyo or may message po ba kayo dun sa papalit sa inyo to ensure na maitutuloy po yung mga policies, mga order nyo po?
It depends who that person is, if it's the president. Okay. My message to whoever will take me place is keep the light shining. Remember and safeguard the Constitution. Can I introduce to you my staff? Okay, this is Marlo Mendoza. He was my classmate in Asian Institute of Management. He is USEC for field operations. A superbly honest man, a forester. There are 7 foresters in his group. But he's intelligent, he's creative, and he's really, really good. Okay, we have here Sylvia Ordonez. So she and Marlo, so Sylvia was taking on the B sites and the IP sites. And Bohol, yeah, and she was taking on climate change. You know, we already got money commitments from the Clean Climate Fund of $100 million. Yeah.
What happens to that?
I know what happens. So that's why Sylvia has something. Yeah, they will stay there. Can you give them a round of applause? Woo! Yeah. Okay, and then we have I have an army here. This is our General Art Valdez. He's the brother of Leo Valdez. I'm not lying to you. He was the head of the team that climbed Mount Everest. Guess how old he is?
68.
See? 68. And he does 500 push-ups every day. Yeah. And his team is, this is my bato. What is he okay? Yeah, they're stopping illegal logging. General Bato, can you call your team? Yeah. I am my X-Men. I am X-Men. X-General.
Woo!
Yeah. We are my team. This is a major X-Men.
General Corpus.
Yeah. Illegal logging, they've been very good at stopping. I told them, bam! And then one strike out. Any DNR official that's there, that's corrupt, bam! You can also tell them. Yeah. Let's give them a round of applause. Woo! Yeah! And then we have the head of my legal team. As you know, I'm not a lawyer. This is Yusek. But now we're the... Come here.
Five past the bar.
Yeah. Okay. And Iban's husband is Howie Severino. Oh, GMA and I'm ABS. Okay. And then where's North? We have all women and one man, and it's very spoiled. Let's give the legal team a round of applause because they work overnight, changing policies. Grabe talaga. Woo! Yeah! And then this is my newest addition, but I don't know if he has a job now. Because he's summa cum laude marketing in Loyola Marymount, magna cum laude law in Rome. But his greatest distinction is in ex-seminarian. Cum laude. So I have many ex-seminarians in Ate. And I want to introduce my staff. Stand up here. Yes, can you? Because they really take care of me. Come here. This is Selena Bailey. And come here. This is Ale. I have millennials. Magaling ba ang millennial? Millennial. Kurang ba kayo or millennial? Okay, I'm here and this is Patty Bailey. Yes! Are they cute or are they cute?
Yeah.
They're so cute and guess what they sing? You want them to sing? You want them to
sing? Ma'am, kayo na lang. Ma'am, kayo na lang. Ma'am, sabi niyo, you believe you can fly.
I believe I can fly. I'll try it on.
Ma'am, paano yun?
Ma'am, my security can come here. He's not millennial, he's a yes, Nor, come here. I have really good staff, you know. We have built a wonderful family, and in these 8 months, we have built a team that really want to make a difference. They're not there for the money. They're there because they love the Filipino, and I think it's this kind of team that can make a difference.
Mom, you believe you can still fly?
Of course. Can you fly? Are you small? I ask you, are you small?
No.
No, you have God inside of you. If you think you're small, you will dream small, you will do small. Are you small?
No.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Okay, so let's sing. I believe.
Yes.
Okay, I'll sing, but you follow me. Yeah? Can you follow me?
I'm
but you have to follow me.
Yes.
But I want to warn you, Tito Soto said, you know, kasi hindi siya marunong kumanta, iboboto ko pa din siya. Alright. Because it's just music. I had a music lessons, and then after 2 lessons, my music teacher left. We'll sing. You'll sing with me. Are you small?
No.
Why? You have God inside of you. You can be anything, you can do anything because you have God inside of you. Okay, so we'll sing.
Yes.
I'll sing and then you follow me. Okay. But you have to follow my hand.
Ma'am, si Eric talented.
Go, ma'am, go.
I believe I can fly. Woo! I believe. I believe.
Are you ready? Yes, ma'am, we're ready. Now
feel the God inside of you, but you have to follow me.
Yes,
ma'am.
I believe I can fly. See?
I believe I can fly.
I believe I can touch the sky.
I believe I can touch the sky.
I think about it every night and day.
Think about it every night.
soar.
I believe I can soar.
See me running through that open door.
See me running through that open door.
I believe I can fly.
I believe I can fly.
Mabait ba kayo?
Yes!
Magaling ba kayo?
Yes!
May bisyo ba kayo?
Ma'am?
No, we will fly.
Ma'am, are you running for a seat in Congress?
No,
or?
I don't like Congress.
No politics from now on? No politics
No, I've seen what, you know, I'll get bored. You know, even when I was in PBS, I like to do it. You just sit there, you talk.
Ma'am, personally po, what are your plans after this setback?
Well, I'll talk to them, and then I have to go to the president. Actually, the NPF invited me the end of May. Joe Masisan invited me the end of May for the peace talks. It would have been easier. Because the thing is, when you're DNR secretary, you're sitting on top of mine. But my passion for the Filipino people remains. And this is not my country, this is all of our country together, right? This is your country!
Yes.
Why are you mahina?
Yes.
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 Yes!
Oh my God! Let's see. Are they cute or are they cute? The IPs are here. Okay, so Sylvia is gonna... So DNR, we've made the policy. Because what happens, DNR used to give land to the IPs. Pero iniiwanan lang sila dyan. Eh kung wala silang pera. So binibenta nila yung right nila sa Chinese. You know, the almasiga. They get the almasiga, they carry it on their backs, and they bring it down, but they don't have trucks. And they don't know where to sell it. So what happens, it goes to the middleman, and then it goes to the Chinese, and they're forever poor. So what we have done is we have instituted policies so that now we're setting up with Sylvia, the Natural Resource Development Corporation, to take away this cycle so that the IPs benefit.